We're going to reach 500 megawatts of fusion power for at least 300 seconds with an energy gain of 10. And by energy gain, we mean the core plasma generates 10 times more power from the fusion than was put into it to heat it up.
And then we want to compress it. The particular way we want to compress it at general fusion is we want to spin a big sort of drum, and we spin the liquid metal like this. The centrifugal force jams the liquid against the wall.
In the heart of southern France, ITER has brought together 35 countries to build the largest tokamak ever, a machine that could potentially revolutionize our energy future. But with high stakes come huge risks, from cutting-edge technological challenges to the complexities of global collaboration. What terrifying risks are lurking in this monumental endeavor? Join us, let us uncover the perils embedded in this colossal quest for energy, the international quest for fusion energy. ITER is located in southern France, where 35 countries have come together to build the biggest tokamak device ever. A tokamak is a magnetic fusion device designed to show that fusion can be a large carbon-free energy source. This project not only shows a big step in our search for sustainable energy, but also stands as the most ambitious mega project in our history. Its development is a key moment in how countries work together on groundbreaking technology that could change how we power our world. The challenges faced in building and managing such a massive project are numerous, ranging from technological hurdles to international cooperation issues. Our stars and sun work through fusion, which could help us create the same kind of energy here on Earth. But how can we do something so big? To understand, we need to look at how fusion works and how a special machine called a tokamak reactor helps create and keep this energy. Fusion is what powers the sun and stars. In their cores, extreme heat and gravity combine lighter elements like hydrogen into heavier ones like helium. This change releases a lot of energy. To do this in a lab, we need three main things. First, we need to reach a temperature of about 150 million degrees Celsius. This heat is necessary to copy the conditions inside stars. Secondly, we need a dense concentration of plasma particles. This density is important because it allows the particles to collide and fuse, which is a key part of fusion. But this isn't the hardest part. The third condition is maintaining these extreme conditions for a long enough time to produce a sustainable energy output. This is where the tokamak reactor comes in. The tokamak is a device that uses powerful magnetic fields to confine the hot plasma, keeping it stable and contained. The tokamak reactor is designed to handle the extreme temperatures and pressures needed for fusion. It creates a donut-shaped magnetic field that traps the plasma inside. By doing this, the tokamak helps keep the plasma hot and dense enough for the particles to fuse together. However, achieving and maintaining these conditions is very challenging. The materials used in the reactor must withstand the intense heat and radiation, which is no easy task. We also need to find a way to efficiently harness the energy produced by the fusion reactions. The energy needs to be captured and converted into a form that we can use, like electricity. Harnessing starlight, the daunting quest for fusion energy. These challenges make fusion research a difficult but exciting field. Scientists around the world are working hard to overcome these obstacles and bring the power of the stars to Earth. The potential benefits are huge. A nearly limitless source of clean energy with minimal environmental impact. Still, the journey to practical fusion energy is long and filled with obstacles. Each step forward brings us closer to a future where fusion could provide a major part of our energy needs. First, the particles in the plasma must be heated to very high temperatures so they move fast enough to collide. Second, the plasma needs to be dense enough to make these collisions more likely. Finally, the plasma must be contained for a long enough time because it naturally wants to spread out. This process involves removing electrons from their nuclei, turning ordinary gas into what is called plasma, the fourth state of matter. This change creates the perfect conditions for light elements to come together and release energy. The tokamak is a clever device made to create and control the conditions needed for nuclear fusion. It uses strong magnetic fields to keep the plasma in place, stopping it from escaping and making sure the fusion process can keep going. The name tokamak comes from a Russian acronym that means toroidal chamber with magnetic coils. This technology was first developed by Soviet scientists in the late 1960s and has become the top method for fusion research around the world. It is very good at maintaining the extreme conditions needed for fusion. But this wasn't the only challenge. As researchers continue to improve this technology, the tokamak is a key part of the search for clean and plentiful energy, showing a great ability to harness the power that fuels the stars. The ITER project aims to build the world's largest tokamak, a type of device that uses magnets to create fusion. This huge machine will be twice as big as any current tokamak and will have a chamber that can hold 10 times more plasma. Inside this giant device, atoms will come together to produce energy. This energy turns into heat, which is similar to how traditional power plants work. The heat then makes steam, which moves turbines and generators to create electricity. The way ITER works is really interesting. It has a donut-shaped vacuum chamber designed to control the plasma, a super hot gas. Large coils around the vessel create magnetic fields to keep the plasma from touching the vessel walls, preventing damage and heat loss. One key part of the tokamak is the cryostat, a structure with a 100-foot diameter. This huge device surrounds the reactor to keep essential parts cool and working properly, despite the intense heat from fusion. This advanced engineering not only helps the reactor work well, but also keeps it safe and long-lasting. Each discovery in fusion brings us new challenges and closer to our energy goals. Harnessing the sun's power. By using nuclear fusion, the same process that powers the sun, ITER aims to create a nearly endless supply of clean energy. This project is a big step forward in our search for sustainable energy, testing new technologies and materials that could change how we power our world. But the challenges don't stop there. The project's complexity and scale mean that every step is a test of human ingenuity and collaboration. In the core of the tokamak, powerful magnets are crucial. They must be strong enough to contain the plasma without letting it touch the walls. If the plasma touches the walls, it could cool down and stop the fusion process. Keeping everything in balance is a constant challenge. The materials used in ITER must withstand extreme conditions. They face intense heat and radiation, and finding materials that can handle these conditions for a long time is a significant part of the project. Scientists are constantly working on solutions to ensure the reactor's durability and efficiency. Yet, overcoming these hurdles is only part of the story. The ultimate goal is to prove that nuclear fusion can be a reliable source of energy. This means not just creating fusion, but doing so in a way that is efficient and economically viable. At the heart of the ITER project, big central solenoid magnets play a key role by creating and keeping the super hot plasma stable. These magnets help the tokamak use 50 megawatts of electrical power to start the fusion process. Once it's running, this process can generate a massive 500 megawatts of power in short bursts. This means the energy output is 10 times what was put in. So what's the goal of this huge project? ITER aims to prove that it can produce 10 times the energy it consumes, showing that fusion power isn't just a dream, but a real possibility. The project also wants to show how different technologies needed for a fusion power plant can work together. Another goal is to create a deuterium-tritium plasma, where the fusion reaction keeps itself going with the heat it makes. This will give researchers a new way to study and improve controlled nuclear fusion, helping them learn more and push the limits of what we can do with energy. This isn't just about making power, it's about leading the way to a future with clean and plentiful energy. But that's not all. ITER is also about pioneering a future where clean and abundant energy could be a reality. Researchers will have a groundbreaking platform to explore and advance the science of controlled nuclear fusion. They'll gain unprecedented insights and push the boundaries of what's possible in energy generation. Fusion isn't just about energy, it's about pushing forward with hope and hard work. Harnessing the stars, ITER's fusion frontier. The project will show the world how fusion energy can be a game changer, offering a sustainable and powerful solution to our growing energy needs. It's not just a project, it's a step towards a brighter, cleaner future. But this isn't just about producing power, it's about making history. ITER is set to be a landmark in energy technology, showing that we can harness the power of the stars right here on Earth. The success of this project could change how we think about and use energy forever. In short, the ITER project is not just a scientific experiment. It's a bold step towards a future where we can produce vast amounts of clean energy. It aims to prove that fusion energy is not only possible, but also practical, paving the way for a new era in energy production. The main goal for the later stages of ITER is to show that it's possible to make tritium inside the vacuum vessel. If successful, this tritium can be used in future power plants. ITER's construction started in 2010 and has gone through several important steps. At first, the focus was on putting together the core machinery and setting up all the systems needed to create the first plasma, which is expected in December 2025. This phase sets the foundation for future testing and operations. After the initial assembly, the facility will move into a phase using deuterium with a small amount of tritium. This stage, planned to be finished by 2035, will test how well the wall shielding works to protect the machinery and handle the intense energy produced during fusion. Success here is crucial because it will give important information on how to contain and manage fusion reactions. The final stage will have ITER running with an equal mix of deuterium and tritium at full fusion power. This phase is the ultimate test of the system's ability to maintain controlled fusion reactions over long periods, which is a key step towards making fusion power a viable energy source. But this isn't the whole story. ITER's ambitious project has also inspired many smaller companies to develop their fusion technology. These efforts create a larger community of research and development that supports the future commercialization of fusion energy. This could lead to a future where clean and plentiful energy changes the way we power our world. In the world of fusion energy, there are many exciting projects happening around the globe. These efforts combine a passion for innovation with scientific research. In the UK, a company named Tokamak Energy is leading the way in developing new technologies to harness fusion power. In California, Tri Alpha Energy, backed by tech giants like Microsoft and Google, is also making great progress. Both of these companies aim to replicate the sun's power to create sustainable energy for Earth. With every experiment, ITER moves us closer to changing how we power the world. Canada's revolutionary fusion design. General Fusion, a Canadian company based in Richmond, British Columbia, is pioneering a unique approach to fusion energy using a technique called magnetized target fusion, MTF. Founded in 2002 by physicist Dr. Michel Laberge, the company has grown significantly over the years, aiming to commercialize fusion energy as a viable power source. Their method involves creating a plasma, which is then injected into a sphere filled with a molten mix of lead and lithium. This mix is crucial as it acts both as a coolant and as a material that helps in breeding tritium, an essential fuel for the fusion process. The sphere is surrounded by steam pistons that rapidly compress the plasma by squeezing the molten metal, increasing the temperature and density to levels where fusion occurs, releasing energy. General Fusion's technology has attracted significant attention and investment, including from major players like Amazon, due to its potential to provide a clean and almost limitless source of energy. The company's development path has included creating multiple prototypes and testing various aspects of their fusion technology. For instance, they have achieved successful plasma injections and compressions that indicate progress toward achieving a stable and sustainable fusion reaction. By 2023, General Fusion launched an ambitious project known as Lawson Machine 26, aiming to reach key fusion milestones and demonstrate a break-even point by 2026. They are also planning to construct a fusion demonstration plant in Canada, which will serve as a significant step towards scaling up their technology for practical use. This approach by General Fusion highlights the potential and challenges of harnessing fusion energy. It underscores the need for significant technological advances and international cooperation to overcome the barriers and make fusion a reliable and affordable energy source globally. The progress of companies like General Fusion and others in the field gives hope for a future where fusion energy could significantly impact our energy landscape, offering a cleaner alternative to traditional energy sources. What are your thoughts on the moral implications of artificial intelligence? Let's debate in the comments below. If you enjoyed this discussion, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.